What's up, guys? My name is Max, and today we're going to be working on this. This is a 2006 Honda VTX 1800. I just picked up as my kind of daily driver motorcycle commuter bike. And as you can see, it's pretty mastodonic. Obviously, 1.8 liter V-twin, and it weighs something in the range of 750, 800 pounds. It was a pain in the butt to get on this table. This is the heaviest bike I've ever had on this table, and it definitely feels it. So I've got it up in the air, it's all warmed up. Basically what we're gonna be doing with it today is my standard, picked up from Craigslist, what do I do with my bike to make sure it's road safe thing. Now I've already ridden it, so I've already aired up the tires, so that's already done. Usually it's the very first thing I do is I check tire pressure, because a lot of times, this bike, when I got it, the tires looked fine, they had 8 PSI in it. And obviously so it made it handle horribly, and it was just not a safe bike to ride. So aired up the tires. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to change the oil. And I'm going to take you guys with me underneath the bike, and I'm going to show you how to do that right now. So the first part of an oil change is to remove the oil fill plug and dipstick, which is located right here on the left-hand side of the bike. So if we're again looking from the shifter side, the left-hand side, your oil filter is located right there, and your oil drain bolt is located right there. 17 millimeter fits perfectly. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna drain all the oil into the pan. While we wait for the oil to drain out, we're gonna check the air filter. Now I didn't order a new one because this bike was supposed to have come with a aftermarket air intake thing. Obviously I don't have it, but we're just going to check to see what condition the air filter's in, clean it out, and if need to, I'll order another one next time. But basically, there's five millimeter screws right here. This cover comes off, the air filter's right behind it. Now, this is what you're going to see. It turns out I have pretty much a brand new factory filter, so we're just going to throw this right back in there. There's a little bit of oil from the blow-by from the engine, totally normal. These guys were super dirty. I always clean the throttle bodies with a little bit of carb cleaner, brake clean, and a toothbrush, and that gets all the gunk off of there. And that's going to help with idling, it's going to help with throttle response, just in general going to make your bike feel and run a lot better. So now this is done, we can put this back together, and I think the oil is drained by now, so we can go and put the plug back in the motor. So we put the plug back in. I always try to break the filter loose and let it drain a little bit. It's a little tight in here, but here in a second, this filter should pop out. There we go. I just usually just let it fall into the pan and let the rest of that drain out for a minute. So on the subject of oil filters, this is what I use, K&N Performance filters. They're a couple bucks more expensive, but here's the reason I use them. I think from a performance side, they're about the same as any quality brand like Wix. But what I really like, and they're the only ones in the market who do this, is they put a 17 millimeter bolt head on the back of your filter. Now, if you're a race guy, it's great because these have a hole for them for you to run a safety wire through, which is a requirement in some racing organizations. But I like them because they're really easy to install and really easy to take off. And especially over time, bikes can get kind of grungy, especially underneath, and the filter can be kind of hard to remove. And this makes it a breeze. On this bike, it's less of an issue, but on sports bikes, where you're trying to get around fairings and stuff, and it's a pain in the butt, this can really be a game changer and totally worth the extra dollar or two. I'll put a link to this filter down in the description below. Next step is we got to add 4 quarts of this stuff. This is what I use, Rotella T4 15W40. It's great. There's no additives or modifiers. I've been using this in motorcycles for probably at least a decade now without any sort of problems on any of these bikes. There was a Delo 400, Delvac are also competitive products that work just fine in motorcycles. Just make sure you get the heavy duty diesel products. Usually it's fine because there's no friction modifiers. So all that's left is to fill this up. This thing takes exactly 4 quarts, which is what's exactly in here. And we'll check it against our dipstick, but just gotta top her up and the oil change is done. And there we go, we screwed in our thing. I ran the bike, checked the fuel level against the dipstick. The oil level against the dipstick, and we're perfect. Next thing, I took off this seat. It has an aftermarket seat. It's really comfortable. Unfortunately, my social agenda dictates that I need a back seat. And so I got to figure out why this hole for the back seat doesn't line up. And so we're going to loosen these bolts here, and now we're going to loosen this guy, and we're going to see if we can get this back to factory straight so we can put the back seat on. Well, with some gentle massaging, got this on here. Previous owner tried to spray paint things black, it would seem. Or maybe the bike got dropped or whatever and he tried to fix it, but it's kind of shitty. Oh, that's not really attached to much of anything, is it? The other thing is, like, he tried to spray paint these black, and I got this one kind of clean. Gotta clean off this one as well. But all that's for later. It's not really important to anything. What is important to stuff is brakes. I'm gonna start with the rear and basically just swap out all of the brake fluid. Never trust other people's brake jobs. So big cruiser bikes like this have big calipers, a lot of lines. So what I've done is I've run a full one of these through, push the fluid through just by hand into one of these little bleeder bottles. You can see there's a bunch of crap in there. You can see the fluid coming out of here is pretty clean. These bubbles are actually from this fitting and not from the brake line. So the back is done. Basically just clean everything off, cap it off, and then we'll lower the bike down slightly so that we can do the same to the fronts. Now, this is one of the things that sucks and you have to be ready for. This screw came out, this one did not. I ended up having to drill it out. You drill out, you pop the head, and then you usually can unscrew this part by hand. But it sucks because now I gotta find another screw, but somebody had already stripped out one of the screw heads, so there wasn't really a whole lot I could do. I use a turkey baster to get all the fluid out of there, and now we're gonna clean up the rest of that shit before we refill it with fresh fluid. Okay, the brakes are bled. I replaced the clutch fluid. Everything is nice and tight. So this bike is a bit of a leg crisper, especially right here at this back pipe. There's clearly some damage here at the header where it mounts up. So there's probably a little bit of blow by right here. But what we're going to do is we're going to make a heat shield to kind of help address this, because I spend a lot of time sitting in traffic and it gets really, really quite hot. And so what we're going to do is we're going to build a heat shield that will mount in here and they'll cover this exhaust pipe. And so what I'm going to do, what I normally do when I do stuff like this is I usually make it out of like a fairly thicker gauge folded steel. And then I hit it on both sides with high temp paint. You can also use a reflective tape or something of that nature. And we're going to mount it to the frame using a couple of riv nuts. So let me take you over here and show you the heat shield that I made. Now this is the piece. I made this with my new Hitachi grinder. Just a regular vise as a press. And so the way this works is that this guy is going to sit, oops, this guy sits right in here. So it's going to be tight up against the head. And so this will block all the heat back in and we'll still be able to use this mount right here for our side cover. So now all I gotta do is drill some holes and riv nut this thing in and maybe clean up a few of these edges because I don't want it to vibrate through the wires. So what I've done is I put a couple of riv nuts here in the frame and that's what we're gonna mount to. So we're gonna test fit everything up right now and probably do a little final grinding, but it really looks pretty good. And this is one of those things where if you take your time and you do it right, you can really get a very aesthetically pleasing result without really having any special tools or special skills. Just a little bit of time and elbow grease. So that's our heat shield in place. Obviously when I went to go put this cover back, this isn't gonna work, so we're gonna have to make some more trims to this. But, you know, again, I think it looks really good. It's not gonna catch on your leg or anything like that, and it's really gonna help, I think, shield a lot of the heat from this exhaust header coming to my leg and just redirect it back towards the engine. So there we go. Got a little custom heat shield in here, help protect my leg from getting burnt up. And this cover can come on and off smoothly without scratching the paint. We got plenty of gap space. Stuff like this that really separates, you know, a factory bike from something that somebody's loved. And this little tiny heat shield after I painted black, nobody is ever going to look at it. Nobody's ever going to see it. Probably nobody's ever going to comment on it, you know, in real life. No one's going to stop me and say, hey, man, that's a super cool looking little heat shield you made. But I know it's there, and I like the way it looks, and, you know, I formed it myself by hand, and there's just a certain value to that that really brings the bike to life for me, especially something that you ride, you know, day in, day out. There is final shot of our heat shield installed.
So you can see it's nice and tight through here. I probably could have cut this angle a little bit less, but this makes it a lot easier to remove without scratching this part. I mean, I know it's all just kind of crappily painted over, but still. But hopefully, this is pretty tight against the cylinder head in here. So hopefully it's going to keep a lot of these gases shielded from kind of coming back out towards my leg. I'm going to do some riding and I'll get back to you guys on whether or not that this was a viable solution. But I'm kind of hoping that it was. That's pretty much it for this bike. I know I said I was going to replace the mirrors. That didn't happen because the wrong mirrors came in. They were junk. And so I'm waiting for a new set. But you guys have seen me screw in mirrors before. It's not really that big of a deal. So the next time you're going to see me and you're going to see this bike is when I do a review on it. I'll do a riding review like I used to do on it. That being said, my name is Max. This is Max Works. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you like the channel, please subscribe. If you want to see more bike review videos, there's a bike review video playlist. There's a bunch of bike build videos on my channel you guys can check out. As always, thanks for watching. Peace!